What is up, guys and gals? It's me, Sasho. Sasho Media. Have you remember? I used to make a gun review videos for Ghost Recon Phantoms. Let's make one in an old, good fashion.
The name is Sasho.
Okay, guys and girls, recently I have been requested to make a review of the new weapon customization for Shadow of Soldiers. Let's see what is the new weapon customizations for Shadow of Soldiers, shall we? Okay, how to get... Okay, I guess I need to search... For Shadow of Soldier, maybe? I don't know. Okay, Shadow of Soldiers. We have Shadow of Soldiers weapon customization 1.1. Oh boy, where I have been with about of 1.0. There we go. Oh boy, this sound effect. All this happening. What? What it says, the title? Weapon customization 1.0 version.
What?
Isn't it 1.0? Isn't it supposed to watch a 1.1 version? Test of parts and attachments, how it affects the weapon stats will be adjusted later. Well, okay, we understand the game is still in development stage, so let's watch it. Okay, since it's review, I'm gonna pause the video. I'm gonna stop it at certain moment. I'm very happy they make it 1 minute and 12 seconds. I'm very happy they're saving everyone's time. So, whoa, what do we have here? What do we have? What's this magazine? I never saw that kind of magazine size. I'm very happy to have an assault rifle with as big as a light machine, a gun magazine. That's always amazing. And having this huge magnified scope, it's always a great one. It makes you competitive against snipers and against other classes. It's really amazing. What do you have so far? Okay, the prices, maybe I'm gonna skip this part. A game still in development, but I would not gonna pay a 25 AC whatsoever is AC. What do we have so far? Fire rate, recoil, magazine size, 60 bullets. This is a 60 bullets. It looks like 1,000 bullets. I don't know. Accuracy, damage, ready time, reload time. So I guess with the version of the customization, we're gonna have changes the weapon stats. So let's watch the video. Whoa. They spent a lot of money here. And I saw some other attachments here. Some other scope. Whoa, we have the 1 point reflex, open reflex, everyone used in GRP. You know why? Because you had to be competitive against CQC and mid-range, but I mean in a range shooting, and when you have a scope for range shooting, you very easy be outplayed in CQC. That's why everyone was using the open reflex. What is this? I don't understand what kind of scope is this? Iron sight. Okay, I do understand of iron sight. Let's watch it again. So we have point reflex, iron sight, red dot. This was the red dot maybe? Yeah, 7,000 for a red dot. I don't mind the price. I don't even know how much I'm gonna earn from a single match. We have the ACOG. Yep, we have a non, double non. Oh, we're gonna change the barrel. Medium, short, DMR. So I guess DMR is that referring for a long range to outplay the snipers on a metro map. Is it SOS going to feature a metro map?
Yeah, we do.
Fuck.
Oh my god, really?
I'm sniping and I'm sniping again.
I'm trolling.
This is gonna hurt.
I don't know, but this is... What is this? A small idea. There we go. The DMR battle is really wonk enough. We have very short battle. Oh, it's by default, it's coming with this default silenced battle where you don't have an option to put any other battle attachments. Kinda fun, maybe kinda okay. I don't know, kinda okay. It looks okay, it's okay, just I'm not sure for the balancing standpoint, but we don't know for what are weapons we have, what kind of other customization. So far, it's fine, it's okay. I approve it. SNC sorry, I barely read the text. It's my fault, probably. Yeah, sorry. The video quality, this is the best video quality of this one so far. Whoa! How this barrel became so larger and so thick? What is this? SEE Bravo? SEE Short? Quadrail? What is happening here? Completely. Is this still the barrel? What we can actually change? The muzzle, the scope, the barrel, the handguard. I guess this is referring for the underbarrel attachment as a grip. Magazine, stock. Underbarrel, it's separate than handguard. What is the handguard? And camo. Yes, of course. Microtransactions detected. Okay. Oh, we're going to change the handbarrel, the handguard. Oh, this is the handguard actually. Sorry, I'm not a weapon specialist, but I'm not sure what is the handguard. Maybe I should a very quick small research. How about that? Weapon handguard. Is it a weapon handguard? Okay. A handguard on a firearm is a guard attached to the front of a firearm to grip the weapon from the front. It allows the user protect from the barrel, which may, I guess, become hot and etc. It allows user to protect from the barrel, which may become very hot when firing. Okay, now we know what is the handguard. Now I'm a weapon expert. Magazine, metal, is it shooting a metal? PMAG and DMAG. Is it any difference between metal and DMAG? I guess this is where you have a variety of a magazine, where I know there is some sort of discussion, like some people calling certain type of magazine a clip. And other people just saying, no, this is also a magazine. So I guess this is what kind of reference here, in terms of where is metal magazine, where is PMAG whatsoever is referring to, and DMAG as well. So I guess this is some sort of type of magazine of different sort of materials created from. Okay, stock, we're gonna customize our stock. We have CRT stock, CBR stock, STD stock. What is this reference? I don't know, but the first plan CRT looks cool. I didn't even see what is changing the ready time. Maybe I'm gonna check out later the stats. The underbarrel, angled grip, angled, vertical grip A, vertical grip B, none. Okay. Oh, we have a small one and a longer one. Okay, maybe I guess the longer vertical A grip. Maybe it's suitable for standing out of cover shooting, aiming for long range, like range shooting, mid to long range to outplay the snipers. cancel. Oh, there we go, the preview of the weapon. That's interesting, actually. Oh, we have this kind of third style rotate. To be. What was the goddamn word? Broken English. Broken English. English. Please be with me right now. English. I need you. English. English. To be honest, I would remove the background. I would remove the background in the weapon customization area. What do you call it? I don't know. I would remove the background. It's distracting a lot. I mean, personally, I don't even like it. But anyway, it's like a cage. You're having your weapon in a cage. Is this a reference from the CSGO where you're out of cage, you're having some sort of item? I don't know. But I mean, guys, don't get me wrong. Just me personally, I mean, I'm talking to the SOS developers. Me personally, I don't like it, but maybe I just like it. But just giving an idea. It's okay. It's a feedback. I'm not saying anything. It's stupid or whatsoever. Just giving an idea. I prefer this kind of style of a GRP where it's some sort of a virtual field, virtual space. You having your weapon and rotating in a virtual, like a single color, like a virtual dimension. Whatsoever space. I know it feels kind of very like unfinished and etc. But I definitely prefer, because I would like to more focus on the item instead of having my eyes looking some sort of other details and etc. Maybe you can make some sort of background, but to be out of focus, like blurred and etc. Maybe this can be, but. Right now, I'm just in a design point of view, like, I mean, as a user, I would like be distracted from and overwhelmed from so much details. Okay, we have some sort of recoil, recoil 18, recoil 27. Oh, there is a difference between, I'm wondering, are you guys featuring a recoil pattern of your weapons? That's actually will be amazing. Well, I'm just watching a video clip of someone shooting, and I don't have the feeling. We cannot see the bullet skull, so I don't know how to compare this. But anyway, we have some sort of comparison about how the animation looks. That's fair. Now we have the fire rate. Okay, definitely here we're losing a lot of control since the aiming increasing vertically. Barrel long, barrel short, so making more damage, making a lot. 92 for okay, 46 damage. We have 46 damage, we have 40 and 80. Okay, there is 6 damage differences, and up to 12 on a critical damage, I guess. Critical shot. I kind of like this. This is a shooting range in the game, I guess. Warm-up, some sort of counter for a warm-up. That's great. That looks very firing rangey of GRP. Okay guys, I see where you're going. Accuracy 91 barrel, accuracy 42. Ooh, such a huge difference in accuracy from 90 dropping to 42 between wonk and short barrel. Whoa, you guys definitely need to look up at your weapon balancing system. Okay, like I don't know, but watching this number, it's a little bit scarce. Maybe I don't know. I have very used with GRP where accuracy amount didn't changing like drastically, sorry, broken English, from that kind of numbers. But anyway, maybe you guys are coming with way different system. Maybe you guys are showing how it should be done in any video games. I don't know. Okay, barely understand. Oh, okay, there is maybe something happening. Like, I would like to rewind back. Is it like damage appear? I mean, Bullet hole, yeah, bullet hole appears, but this targeting plate seems to be next to the character. So you having the same target display appeared next to the to your character. That's interesting game design feature we're seeing right now, guys and girls. I'm a little bit amazed. That's okay. That's nice. Let's see the next one. Yeah, we can see exactly when this one's shooting, it appear here the weapon holes where the damage where the bullets lands on the target. And the same goes here. There we go, shooting and land here. Okay, that's nice. That's pretty nice actually. So we have some sort of connection between the range target and the target and the display target. I don't know how should be called. Just trying to make some sort of terms here. So the display target actually shows the where the bullets land on this far target. Nice one. Keep up the good work. We have that kind of field, another testing of a ready time testing. Let me try again. We don't know what is the weapon and weapon customization right now, but what the heck? I can see the left one, it seems to be like the lowest ready time for me. Seems to have the longer animation. Let's watch it again. Yeah, I feel like the no, actually this one it's stopping a bit later, but I guess yeah, of course it's been recorded separately, but it's definitely pulling out the weapon way more faster. Yeah okay, I can see where it goes. It feels very kind of equal, but not that much if you... What the frick? Get out menu. If you watch it very careful. Like, I definitely feel that this one... Yeah, okay. The worst ready time is definitely the worst ready time. That's it. Okay. I'm fine for this game. I'm buying. Okay, guys and gals, I hope the SOS developers are very happy. I mean, the Shadow of Soldiers developers are very happy with this video. They have requested me to make it. Yeah, I've decided. Okay, let's do it. Maybe you guys and gals are interesting to see my personal opinion. Also to shout out the game development project of the Shadow of Soldiers. Check out their work so far. I'm gonna definitely feature down into below the video description the Shadow of Soldiers YouTube channel and like some sort of social media stuff, so you can check out them. Okay, guys and gals, let me know of course your opinion about the weapon customization of the Shadow of Soldiers. Let me know what do you think as well. I would like to read your comments. And of course, thanks for watching. Maybe give a like if you like the video. Maybe subscribe if you're new and coming from the Shadow of Soldiers videos and you never watch my videos.